I'm here at Huxham Cross Farm in Devon, in England. This farm was once described as a miserable piece of land. It's 15 hectares and used to comprise three fields of continuous barley, two fields that were too wet to farm, one field that was taken out of agriculture and just sprayed with herbicides every year. In 2015, Marina O'Connell took this over, and she realized that this didn't require sustainable agriculture. This needed to be regenerated. It needed to be restored. So she applied a whole set of regenerative farming principles. One was key line plowing. So the key line is the point at which the slope moves from being convex to being concave, and that point at the middle where it flips is the key line. And so they plowed along that key line, and this was deep subsurface plowing, not exposing the surface, but going half a meter down, reducing the compaction, adding air, adding ability for water to move through that, introducing the capacity for more life in there. And there's agroforestry, the mix of trees, 2,500 fruit and hazelnut trees, and crops. And there's what's called alley cropping or intercropping, so that there's rows of trees and in the middle there's crops. And there's contour planting, so the lines of trees run along the contours, so the water, rather than running downstream and flooding the village as it used to, is retained, is held back, goes down in the roots, is held in the water, or is returned to the aquifer. And there's polyculture. There's a mix of different species grown. Overall, 100 species of varieties of plants are grown on this farm. You can see diversity of different plants with clover going in amongst it. There's also a lot of care for biodiversity. There's lots of areas that are kept to maintain diversity of a whole range of different species. There's lots of work with the community. So training courses, people are encouraged to visit. There's a cafe, there's a shop. It's a very much a community center. It sells lots of local food to the local communities. Flowers are grown. There's mixed farming, so that there's chickens and pigs and manure as a result. The fields that were too wet to farm are now grazed with
Shetland cows,
with stunning benefits for the orchids and a range of other species. There are more fruit being grown. There's buffer strips that are put around the headwater of the River Dart to stop runoff and pollution affecting the rivers. There's green manures. So here's some, they grow deep green manures and cover the land. So there's very rarely bare material, bare surface of the soils, and set of polytunnels as well. And this has switched from being a farm that provided very little in terms of employment or food production or other benefits, to one that employs 12 people. After 5 years, it was producing 40,000 eggs, 15 tons of fruit and vegetables, honey, chickens and pigs and cattle, and creating a lot of interest within the local community. So regenerative agriculture is a complicated subject. And there's a whole set of different related ideas here. But what this shows is that it really can work and really can make a difference. Some of these ideas are very much traditional agriculture. Some of these ideas are adopted by communities all around the world. You know, agroforestry is not a new idea, or polyculture is not a new idea to many cultures around the world. But with increasing interest in not just producing food, but thinking about soils, thinking about water, thinking about carbon, thinking about biodiversity, thinking about the general services, thinking about sustainability, there's increased interest in regenerative agriculture and the possibilities that it has. And we need to think hard about these sorts of approaches and the evidence that underlies them. So I think that one of the great legacies that Marina's left us is a lovely example of how effective this can be and how land can be transformed.